Yeah. So dragonflies are super cool. Well, they are famous because we know there's a superhero called Dragonfly. And there are many reasons why they could be super cool. Because they are one of the ancient insect orders which are still surviving. They are semi-aquatic in nature. They come in all sorts of shapes, sizes and colors. They look beautiful. They have this beautiful mating reel position which looks like a heart and could make a very good Valentine gift again. So you must be wondering how to identify dragonflies from lamsun, right? So it's pretty straightforward. Dragonflies sit with their wings open, and damselflies they sit with their wings closed. Dragonflies are heavily built, and damselflies are slender bodied. Dragonflies have these eyes which are confluent, touching each other, and in damselflies you can see the eyes are separated. So the taxonomy is not really complicated, and a lot can be done with just looking at the posture, size, shape, colors, and flying pattern of this species. So even if you have a good photographic field guide, you can be a good odonator. So let's start identifying some of the species. So is it a dragonfly or a damselfly? Dragonfly, right? It's one of the commonest species, crimson marsh glider. The name itself explains the color, and that it's a glider. It's a Labridae family member. So all the Labridae family members are called gliders. You can see the male is brightly colored and female is dull colored. So in general, in dragonflies and damselflies, males are brightly colored and females are dark colored. There is a sexual dimorphism, but not in all the species. You can see that the wings in the male are tinted in the at the base, and the wing venation is crimson colored. You can see these lines over here. This is called wing venation. This is also used for the taxonomic identification. It's a key for classifying all these odonata. Whereas female has this yellowish abdomen with lateral black stripes across the abdomen. And also the eye coloration of females and males, they differ. So you see, there is a lot of color component in identification of dragonflies. So that's why it's easy, because we can see color. Is it a dragonfly? Damselfly, right? So Senegal golden dotted, it's one of the widespread species and also a much studied species. You see that there are different morphs of females. You see there is a normal female, that is a common morph that you see, and then there is heterochromatic brownish red morph of females, and then there is something called andromorph which resembles the male coloration. So this is actually a strategy of a female to avoid frequent copulation attempts by males, when in a population there are many more males than females. So this is an interesting phenomenon, we can talk about it later on. You can see in this pair, both of them resemble same, but this one is a male, this one is a male, and this one is a female. Deep jewel, dragonfly, right? It's another common species, and the scientific name says Brachythemis contaminata. This is a pollution tolerant species. You can see them in polluted waters of Bangalore. Males have this distinct tint on the middle of the wings, and also this reddish orange colored wing spots. Females have these golden colored wing spots. Both these species you can find in polluted water. Another interesting species, wandering glider or globe wanderer. As the name suggests, it has a wide range. It wanders across the globe. Pantala, which is also a species which migrates from India to Africa. And this is an incredible migration because it migrates over the sea. It is also the highest flying dragonfly. It flies around 6,200 meters above the sea level in Himalayas. There is not much dimorphism in males and females in these species. Males and females, they look same, but the males are a bit brightly colored, but you may not be able to identify them just by looking at a picture. few minutes to catch them, and it's very difficult because you see they're always in the air. They do everything in the air. This is a damselflower, right? So we have saffron flesh blue dart. The face, the mouth parts of this species is saffron color, and it's a beautiful azure blue colored damselfly with black stripes. I have put in a picture of a male, and the female is not very visible, but you see the female is laying eggs underwater and male is holding the female at the prothorax. So this behavior is called mate guarding. We can also talk about this later on. A very beautiful and big dragonfly called blue dunner or magnificent emperor, family Ashnidae. These species, males are blue colored and females are, you know, greenish colored. You see a female laying eggs underwater over here. These species are really difficult to photograph because they are fast flying, as you can see in this picture. So Saurabh has got this really incredible picture. The male is very fast flying and it's really difficult to take the pictures of this species. Another common dragonfly that you can find in Bangalore, that's called common club-tail, appropriately named as Asian tiger because it has this distinct black and yellow stripe pattern. And interesting thing about this species or this family, Bomphidae, is that it has a club-shaped tail. So that's why it's called club-tail. And there is a male and then a female. The female has a, in the males, the tail is pretty sharp. You can see the anal appendages, which are over here, this one, which are pretty sharp. These, the males used to hold the females at the prothorax, and the females, they don't have much developed anal appendages. So that's also one of the differences by which you can identify males and females. Dragonfly and damselfly, what is it? It's a damselfly called spread wing because it sits with the wing spread, which is a characteristic of dragonflies, but it's pretty much a damselfly because you see the slender body and the eyes are separated. So this species is also a beautiful species, generally occurs in the scrublands and grasslands, and it has this color pattern which is brown in color. So it's a camouflage color for the habitat that it lives in. How will you identify this species? It's very simple. You just see the thoracic pattern of the species. So all the lesteri members, they can be identified with the looking at the thoracic pattern. So here you see there is a hockey stick marking, emerald colored hockey stick marking on the thorax. So that's a characteristic of Lester Silatus, the emerald spreading, and the color is also beautiful emerald. So that's pretty much about it. You learn all these 10 species that I showed you. It's pretty simple and pretty straightforward. You can identify dragonflies with the use of online resources. So there are some fantastic books available. There's a book by Subramanyam and there's a book by Nair. Both these are photographic e-books and they can be downloaded and it can be used. We have a Dragonflies of India group on Indo-Biodiversity portal, where we have more than 2,500 observations now and more than 500 users. We also have a Dragonfly India group on Facebook, where we have more than 5,000 members. We conduct these meets. You see the picture here. That's from last meet that happened in Tattekar. Previous to that, a meet happened in Nagpur. This year, the meet will happen in West Bengal. So if you are interested in joining us, you can also, you know, contact me maybe in later on. We also maintain a website called Odonata of India, which is a moderated website. It's not open, as in it's open, it's available, but the data is not open like IBP has. So these are the activities also which are connected, interconnected, and there are participants which are also on IBP, also on the Facebook group, and also on Odonata of India. So everything is pretty much connected. Yeah, thank you.